Okay, let's continue discussing the RA model. But before we proceed, i-modify ko lang yung mga variables na diniscuss ko in the previous video. So this resistor, instead of calling this RD or dynamic resistance, papalitan lang natin yun ng RE. And equal pa din naman siya sa 26 millivolts divided by, instead of ID, papalitan lang natin yun ng emitter current. Okay? And itong current source natin sa taas, instead of calling this collector current, equal din naman yan sa beta IB, or yung current gain ng transistor multiplied by the base current. Okay, so convert natin itong RE model into common emitter configuration using two-port system. Si two-port system ginagamit yan, no, for ease of analyzation, para mas mapadali yung pagkuha ng input and output impedance, and also the voltage and current gain. Okay? So, with the word two-port system, dalawa yung port na ginagamit natin for input and output. For the left port, dito natin normally kinukuha si input, and dito rin natin minimeasure si input impedance. Ito yung ating circuit. And yung right port, dyan naman natin minimeasure yung output natin. And also, yung output impedance. Okay? So, convert natin yung two-port configuration itong common emitter. Okay? So, start tayo dito sa input. So, yung input natin is dito natin kinukuha sa base to emitter. Ito yung input natin. And then, dito rin natin minimeasure yung input impedance. And sa output, dito naman natin i-measure sa collector to emitter. And also yung output impedance natin. Okay? So, try muna natin mag-derive ng expression for input impedance. So, ZI is also equals to VBE divided by IB. Since VBE is also equals to RE, multiplied by IE, so divided by IB, palitan lang natin yung IE ng IB plus IC. So RE multiplied by IB, yung IC natin is also equals to beta IB. So palitan lang natin ng beta IB divided by IB, and cancel natin si IB since common naman siya sa dalawang term. Matitira for this expression is beta plus 1 R. Since yung beta natin is nagre-range from 50 to 100 or even more, no, depende sa transistor na ginamit, normally si 1, nine-neglect na lang natin yan kasi masyadong maliit yung value ni 1 compared sa value ni beta. Okay? Kaya si ZI, normally ginagamit in most of the electronics books, is equals to beta R. Okay? Or almost equal to beta RE. Okay? So, drawing natin yung two-port system for the input side. So, this is the base terminal. This is the emitter terminal. And ito yung input impedance for common emitter configuration. So, beta RE. And for the output, yung output natin is collector to emitter. So, meron tayong current dyan. Yung current natin is IE. Or also equals to, or almost equals to IC. No? Kasi kung maaalala nyo, yung IC is almost equal to, or equal to alpha IE. And yung alpha natin is normally is 90% to even 100%. Okay. So yung IE is sometimes ginagamit IC. Okay? Kasi almost equal lang naman sila. Okay? So ito yung collector to emitter, and dito yung output natin. And dito naman yung ating input. Okay? So may nalimutan pa ba tayo? I think meron pa tayong nalimutan isa, yung output resistance. Kung maaalala nyo, yung collector characteristic curve ng ating transistor, which is nagiging constant siya, no? So medyo mataas siya at the first pag na-reach niya na yung VCE sat, saturation ng collector to emitter, nagiging constant niya si collector current. So this is IC and yung ating x-axis is the collector to emitter voltage. Okay? And ito yung, this is specific for one value of base current. So yung slope nito, slope niya is, slope is equals to delta IC over delta VCE, which is 1 over RO, or yung output resistance ng collector to emitter natin. And as the value for collector to emitter goes from 0 up to infinity, yung slope natin nagiging constant or nagiging 0. Kaya yung value ni RO is nag-a-approach to infinity rin. Okay? So for the sake of computation sa fixed bias, sa voltage divider bias, and even for emitter bias, nilalagay na lang natin muna yung value ng RO. Just RO lang, no? Wala tayong ilalagay na value dyan kasi hindi naman natin alam yung value kasi sobrang laki niya. And normally, nag-range yan from 10 ohm up to 10 mega ohm. Or even higher, giga ohm. Depende sa problem. Okay? So, itong circuit na to is the complete two-port system RE model for common emitter configuration.